Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of The Beat, dear viewers. The Beat is a program, which is a musical one. It takes you all around Egypt and brings you the latest singers, the latest composers in Egypt, the most renowned ones, not only national ones, but international ones as well.
Started the idea of having a band, musical band, that plays a cover version of the English and the French songs for the audience, Egyptian audience. We started this band when we were in the secondary school, it started with Dr. Saba, Engineer Tahir, and myself. We were in friends at school, and our school was a French school, Collège de la Salle. This was the first ignition of the band. With our pocket money, allowance we get from our parents, we started to spend some money to buy instruments, to buy music equipment. Very poor budget. But we started. And when we started, that was the wonderful virus that we couldn't get out of it until now. I'm 68, and we started since we're 19. These long years, full of passion, of music, and to give the art the worth it deserves. It's the pleasure of life. I remember our first show we made, our first appearance we made was with a very budgetary equipment. The less we can afford to pay. I still remember that the audience had some concerns about what we are presenting in terms of music and art. But with the experience we had, we started to see people recording from the stage. And that was the first signal we received that we are presenting something that works to hear. And from here we started to make albums. Our first album, I remember, the name was Shed El Hazam. It was wonderful. And I was the man who printed the label of the cassette. I made millions of this.
Cassette, it was really a great success, so we started to be requested in every governorate in Egypt, nearly all of them, Mansoura, Gharbeya, Dahleya, Alexandria, everywhere, and it was a great feeling because we were not expected this kind of reception over there, so and we found that before reaching the governorate, even from about 5 kilos before entering the governorate, for example, of Kalubeya or Suez, we found people on the roads cheering us and waiting for us since hours. And we thought that we were the Beatles at that time of Egypt. So it was really wonderful. And it was nearly every week we had a performance all over the governments in Egypt. And We had also some requests abroad, outside Egypt, but unfortunately some of us couldn't leave due to the, some reasons, so we didn't have the opportunity to go outside Egypt for such performance. But it was a lovely moment to feel the success and to feel it and to come near the people and to be with them all the time. After that, we started our second cassette. So we started with a different system this time, because the first time it was really a good registration. How do you say? We registered the songs on stage live, but for the second cassette, we started to book a studio, and we went to a studio to perform the songs over there and professionally. So with a sound engineer and everything.
In the beginning, as a teenager, like any other teenager, we've been have a hobby to play music, and then we met me and Samir and Saba, and we start a band called the Jets, and then we start playing in the beginning foreign songs, and then somebody came and played with us and said to us, why don't we play some Arabic music? And then we start Arabic music, and we got a great success with two, three tapes. We made it in the beginning, like Shad El Hizam and Metin Alou. And then after some years, 10, 15 years, we separated because of the career of life. Every one of us has been working in his career of life. And then I still playing music, but foreign music again, till I went, I'm married to a foreign girl. So I went to Denmark, I got some courses in sound, and I became a sound engineer. And then I stayed still attached to the kind of music, because I've been making big concerts and these sort of things. I worked with many of the big stars in Egypt, and I traveled all over about 20 countries making big concerts and events there. And then we met again after 20, 25 years, 30 years, we met again, and we said, why don't we play to enjoy ourselves? It's not a matter that we, it's not a matter of working, it's a matter of getting the hobby and the feeling of the reunion of big, very attached friends to each other. So we started again making some songs with each other, and we start playing concerts again, and we start playing in the Sawi. It was the first concert for us, and we made the program with Saad Younis, Madame Saad Younis, and we felt it's very enjoying to meet the group, the old group of before, which you can never forget your friends from before in the beginning. And it was a big enjoyment for me to have this kind of meeting, all the souvenirs coming back again to you. And we made two, three concerts, and we're still meeting each other and making some music together, and that's all. Je dois te rencontrer. C'est écrit dans le ciel. Et que je dois t'adorer. C'est écrit dans le ciel. Que je vivrai que pour toi. C'est écrit dans le ciel. Et que tu peux croire à moi. C'est écrit dans le ciel. Lay 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 lay.
كيفو 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 يشرب على كيفو كيفو يا مصطفى يا مصطفى.
singer, no, as a group. So it became something different. We had a special character starting from this cassette. We found a special character for the Jets. So the people and the Egyptians and all the Arab world were really happy with this new style, because before that it was the style of one only singer, not a group. So we were the first one to be on the market as a group. And we had very, 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 very success everywhere in the Arab world, and even abroad in Canada, States, and Australia. All the immigrants, the Egyptian and the Arab immigrants over there, we received letters and calls from them cheering us. And the young people, they have they know by heart our songs, the words, the music and everything. It was really nice, really nice. To tell you the truth, for me, if I had to do the things and to return back again from the start, and I know that I am going through this route, I would have taken it more professionally from the very start, because it gives another sensation and another quality of performance and how do you say, another quality of music and singing. And so I would have liked to do it again, but more professionally, because it came like this by luck. For the first time, the first cassette, it came by luck. So if I go back, I would like to have it again, but this time by a plan. You know how what I mean, planning this first and this second and so on. And I would like to do it again and again and again, because this feeling, no matter how I tell you, you will never feel it unless you are there in the middle of the show. Thank you very much, and till we meet again.
Cairo, oh Cairo, where I have
NLD viewers, this is all for today's episode of The Beat. Hope you've enjoyed being with us as much as we have. And until we meet again in another episode of The Beat, from all the team here, myself, your host for today's episode of The Beat, Ram Al Qassas, thank you so much for joining and stay with us. We'll always be around The Beat, we'll always be everywhere, bringing you the latest in music.